Now, it's a brave woman who takes on Corrie's Tracy Barlow, as Cathy has been finding out in Weatherfield.
I bet that they've pocketed the lot.
Surely not.
What?
What?
There's people here saying that we're ripping off Oliver's fund.
It's Brian Packham.
The troll.
This is his revenge.
Oh. Oi! Vandal! I'm gonna phone the police!
Not nice, is it?
No, in broad daylight.
Now you know what it feels like when people turn on you.
Brian, I can give you all the answers you need. I wrote something mean on the website.
Something mean?
Everyone thinks it was you that posted it.
You're all over the papers, Brian. Bin him off, you could do so much better.
It was me, okay? I was the one that posted the comment about Steve.
You think it was bad before?
Oh dear, Corrie's Cathy Melanie Hill is with me now. Good morning, Melanie.
Morning, Kat. Welcome back.
Thank you so much. Lovely to chat to you, by the way, Melanie. Lovely to chat to you. Now, tell me, things are about to get so much worse for Cathy now that they know that it was her, right?
Yeah, it's a bit of a disaster for poor Cathy. She never meant to cause this much of a furore. And it was one of those things of basically don't drink and tweet. We've all been there. But she makes the mistake of making a comment, and this just gets a life of its own. And it's more the comments that come after what she's put that cause the problem. And people nowadays, I think with the pandemic, the social media is quite toxic at the minute, and things just turn really nasty, and it's not a good situation for her.
Yeah, well, it's our way of communicating with people at the moment as well, I think. Is she going to leave Weatherfield for good, do you think, or will she come back? What do you think?
Well, she leaves the cabin. Basically, Brian and Cathy obviously bought the cabin, but the business is in trouble because everyone's boycotted it and things get quite dark quite quickly. So she feels that she wants to protect the people that she loves. So she decides to move out. And it's just how far she goes, because that's the big question. She might not go too far.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
And I've signed another contract for another year, so. But there will, which is brilliant. But we'll see how it plays out, because I mean, it is quite a serious situation, and the community at Coronation Street's obviously got a very tight knit community, and they all band together to really boycott the cabin because of what's happened. And it gets really nasty, really, and it shows how easy it can happen. And to be honest, I would like to say it's interesting that they gave this story to an older character, because you would have thought it would be one of the younger ones, but I think it proves how easy it can happen to anybody. Just make a comment without thinking, and it's out there on the internet, and you know, it's got a life now there, and it never goes away.
How do you deal with social media in real life, Melanie?
Well, I love and hate it. Yeah. I came off Facebook about a year ago.
Yeah.
And I'd miss out at first, but then I feel so much better, because I don't feel tied to checking in on things all the time. And I've still got Twitter and Instagram, but I don't really use them a lot. I usually use them to post skies and nice things, just to, you know, things that I like looking at. But
yeah,
I haven't been trolled, but I've seen people get trolled, and it's horrible, horrible, toxic things people write. And I think it's easy to, from your own bedroom, to say things that you would never say to somebody if you were sitting opposite them. And obviously a lot of people are locked in their houses now, so
yeah,
that's what they're doing more.
I agree with you. It's very easy to be brave when you're faceless and nameless. Very easy. I know that this role in Corrie was a dream job for you. And it's always, if you're going for your dream role, it makes the audition process very nerve-wracking. How was your audition?
Well, apart from it being Corrie, you know, yeah, it's iconic. I it was a disaster really at first, because I set off to do my audition walking from Manchester City Centre, because I thought I would be all zen when I got there and calm. And I got lost, completely lost. So I was an hour late and sweating terribly. perspiring. And I brought all my props like an idiot. I've been acting for nearly 40 years and I don't know why I did it, but I brought all my props with me and they would not let me take them on set into the studio. So they gave, it was an umbrella I had to have, and they gave me their umbrella. And the first take, I was shaking like a leaf. I walked in, opened the umbrella, and it wouldn't open.
Oh, no.
So that was it. I know, I was just awful at this. Cut, and had to go back out and start again, and it wasn't nice.
But you got it. All's well that ends well. I remember you from, because on Sunday nights, we'd always have bath night, and it'd be hair wash night with my mum, and I used to watch you on Bread, playing Aveline. I love that.
Yeah. Blimey. God, that's a throwback, isn't it? What a joy. That was fun. That was a fun job. The costumes were great. But mind you, the last series I shot of that, I was carrying my daughter, Molly. Nice. And the shoes, well, that wasn't pleasant when you're 9 months pregnant, no, walking around in 8-inch heels.
No, so. It was always, I want to be a model, Mum. I'm going to be on the glosses. I love it. Tell me, how has it been shooting Corrie during these COVID times? How's that been?
It's tough, but yeah, we are lucky to be working. You know, yes, we're aware of that. There's not a lot of people in the building. It's hard to socialise because you've got masks on and you're aware of the fact we're not allowed in each other's dressing rooms. There's not really a green room. But and the hardest thing is, to be honest, is rehearsing in a mask, because you can't see people's faces to react. You can't hear them. So it's been tough, but, you know, we've done it. And thank God we're still able to make telly. That's the main thing. We're lucky to be doing it.
Absolutely, absolutely. And lucky to be healthy. Thank you so much for joining us, Melanie, this morning.
It's a pleasure. It's nice to see you anyway.
It's lovely to see you too. And happy birthday. I know you've got a big birthday coming up. So happy birthday for then.
OK, thank you. We don't talk about birthdays in our house.
I'm not going to say an age. I would never reveal, Melanie. You can trust me.
Don't forget, you can watch full episodes of Lorraine on the ITV Hub and all the best clips, compilations and playlists right here on our channel. Just subscribe now and you'll never miss an upload. Click here to watch another video similar to this one, or click here to head to our channel's homepage to explore all of our exciting videos.